Hello, everyone. I am here today to talk to you about whether or not Kegel exercises really work. And so I bet you're hoping that there's an easy and simple answer to that, but alas, there is not. It's complicated. And I'm afraid I'm about to muddy the waters for you all, but I want to give you factual information. So just be prepared to hold on to your hat. This isn't a simple yes or no answer. So there are three questions that we need to look at when we determine whether or not Kegel exercises really work. The first is, should you be doing them at all? I don't know why I used my pinky finger. Let's get the index out. The second question is, are you doing them correctly? And the third question is, what is the right program for you to achieve what your body needs to achieve? So starting with the first question, should you be doing Kegels? We've said this before, we'll say this again, we've got a lot of resources out there on this subject, but many, many people should not be doing Kegel exercises or any strengthening exercises. Many of us have too much tension in our pelvic muscles. To add a little more complexity, I will mention that it is possible to have weakness and tension at the same time. I know it feels like it should be one or the other, but a great example is when you get a Charlie horse in your calf. It doesn't matter if you have super strong calf muscles or weak calf muscles, you can still get a Charlie horse there. So with that sort of as an example, the pelvic muscles can be weak, but also be holding too much tension or be in spasm. And it may be that you do need to strengthen, but that first we need to address that tension. If we start trying to crank on those pelvic muscles to strengthen them by doing Kegels when they are already holding too much tension, we're going to make our problems worse instead of better. So let's assume you've been checked out and indeed you do need to strengthen. Well, the next question is, can you do a Kegel correctly? Research tells us that the majority of people cannot, that when they think that they're doing a Kegel, they're not engaging the correct muscles in the correct way for the exercise to be effective. And so that would be the next step. And then if and when, let's go with when, I mean, you'll learn, right? If you're not doing it correctly now, that's what we're here to help you with. When you're able to do it correctly, then the question is, what's the right program for you? So let's say that I was going to go to the gym to work on my biceps. And as you can see, I need a lot of work. I haven't been doing a lot of biceps exercises. All right. And so next to me, I've got a personal trainer and we're going to work on my biceps. Next to me is a big bulky, let's go with woman. Let's not make this a gender thing. A woman that's in there a lot and she's also working on her biceps, but she's been working on her biceps for a year and she's already got quite a lot of muscle tone going on. So what I need and what she needs are not going to be the same, right? I'm probably going to need lighter weights and maybe she's going to do more reps than me, or maybe she's going to do fewer reps than me with much higher weights. Our bodies are different and what we're working on is different. So the same is true with the pelvic muscles. It depends on where you're at and where you're trying to go and what you need, what you should be doing. So the problems with Kegel exercises is that many people, A, aren't doing them correctly, and B, if they're doing them, they have no instruction on what to do and what, you know, for that's right for their body. So you can do squeeze, let go, squeeze, let go, squeeze, let go all day long and achieve nothing. However, you can do a Kegeling program that is extremely effective if you're doing them correctly and if you're doing a program that's right for your body. Because there is not a one-size-fits-all, I cannot tell you what that is. That is, you know, for all of these reasons, starting with should you even be doing them, this is why it's really important to at least have a consultation with a trained pelvic health professional before embarking on a Kegel program. And I am well aware that there are not pelvic health therapists in every area of the United States and even the globe. So this is something that we can help people with via telehealth if you're not able to find someone local to work with you. So I'm sorry that I didn't have a little more straightforward answer for you, but I hope that that was helpful and that you got what you needed out of it. Thanks.